بزيدني علما إن الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. I'm here, my dear Muslim brothers and sisters, to give the good news to all those out there that who wants to establish a stronger relationship with the Book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and with the Sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we will not be able to do so the way it's supposed to be unless we learn the language of the Book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, unless we learn the language of the Sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My dear brothers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He chose this particular language for the last and final revelation, the Quran. That means there is a wisdom behind it. That why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, among those million languages out there, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He chooses this particular language for His last and final revelation also, and for His Prophet also. So my dear brothers, wallahi, as I go around the universities, especially like Inter University, Nilai University, Legenda University, I went to a lot of places. So people, especially mashallah, those who don't want to just be suffice, and for those who's just a little knowledge of Islam is not enough, just the basics of Islam is not enough, but they really want to go deeper and deeper and deeper, and for that case they really have a strong passion to learn the language of the Quran, to learn the language of the Book of Allah and Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So they really show a lot of willingness to learn this particular language. So here is the chance, my dear brothers and sisters, you have to learn this particular language of the Quran. And our Sheikh is a doctor who did PhD in only in Arabic, alhamdulillah. So this is the treasure we have, that we can benefit from his particular knowledge. So Sheikh is here with us, alhamdulillah. So he will explain you from his words that how he is going to teach the Arabic and what is his way to teach the Arabic, biiznillah. So in another manner, he is going to introduce this particular course to you, inshallah. So let's listen to our beloved Sheikh, inshallah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وبه نستعين وعليه توكلان اللهم صل وسلم على نبينا محمد وآله وصحبه الحمد لله. First of all, I would like to introduce myself. I'm Lukman Abdelghani. I have my PhD in Developing Arabic Syntax, Developing Arabic Syntax Teaching Method. Also my master degree in teaching Arabic to non-Arabic speakers, and my first degree in Arabic language from Islamic University of Medina. I also have a diploma in Arabic language from Islamic University, Niger Republic. But when we are talking about the Arabic language, there can be no doubt that learning the Arabic language should be one of the top priority, and indeed, it should be seen as one of the basic necessities for a person who wishes to study Islam and for those who wish to impart Islamic knowledge to others. By this, we know, we as a Muslim, we know that the Arabic language is compulsory for us. Some may ask, why Arabic language is compulsory? Okay. Or in another way, some may ask, why we need to learn Arabic language? Yeah, we need to study Arabic language because of these following reasons. One, the Arabic language is the language of our religion. That's number one. Two, the Noble Quran was revealed by this Arabic language. And for Muslims to read the Quran and understand the meaning of the Quran, it is compulsory for me and you to understand, to learn this Arabic language in order to understand the word of Allah. Three, just as the Quran came to us in Arabic language, the Sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam came to us as well. In this way, we know and we believe that the Arabic language is is compulsory for me and you to know, to learn, to understand, in order to understand the Al-Quran and Hadith Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, how to know about our religion better. Lastly, we know that the Arabic language is one of the most widely spoken language in the world. You want to do business in anywhere in the world, once you understand the Arabic, it's enough for you. You as a Muslim, anywhere you are in the world, once you understand Arabic language, you can communicate with anybody in the place you find yourself. Maybe you are in Arab country, or you are in Africa, or you are in Asia, even though when you are in America, many people now are speaking Arabic, both Muslim and non-Muslim. But you as a Muslim, you have to know that the Arabic language is more compulsory for me and for you to learn because of the reasons I already told you before. So, okay. Therefore, this organization, Attazkiyya Institute, set up a program of teaching Arabic language in short time period within 6 months. And this 6 months divided into three. The first 2 months, we are going to learn about the Arabic vocabularies, just word by word. For the complete 2 months, inshallah ta'ala, whoever participates, always be in the class and be focused. In this class, we are going to know not less than 200 words in Arabic language. Not only this word, not only vocabulary, I mean. You are going to know this word and applying it. How do you use it? For example, when I ask, what is this? In Arabic, you say, hadha jawalun, ma hadha? Hadha jawalun. Okay. Madha taf'al bi jawal? What are you doing with answers? Madha taf'al bi jawal? So, now we know the meaning of jawal. Jawal is mobile. Mada tefal. What are you doing? We already know this also. Mada de tefal. Inshallah, 3 days in a week, within 2 months, we are going to learn not less than 200 words in Arabic language, inshallah ta'ala. And for the second 2 months, we are going to learn about sentences in Arabic. As you know, the Arabic sentence is divided into two. So we have what they call al-jumlatu al-ismiyya, and the other is al-jumlatu al-fi'liyya. Inshallah, for the second 2 months, so you will know how to construct the sentence, simple sentence in Arabic, based on jumla ismiyya and fi'liyya. And the last 2 months, inshallah, we are going to learn about the grammar, Arabic grammar. So, nahwu, sarfu, also al-balaga. This can help you to understand Al-Quran better and hadith, our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You can ask me how. Yeah. For the first semester, you know about the words, many words in the Quran, many words in the Hadith, many words in, the thing we always use, like pen, like chair, like table in Arabic, like TV, like watch, or whatever, anything we always use. Our things we are using. So once you know this thing for the first semester, in the second semester, you are going to know how to join it together. But in the third semester, inshallah, that's the last 2 months, we are going to know the grammatical law in Arabic language. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, Kul, bada a'udhu billahi minash shaitani rajim, Kul, a'udhu bi rabbin nas. Kul, is it now or verb? We are going to know how to differentiate between now and verb. Okay, let's say kul is a verb. Which kind of verb is this? Is it madi or mudari or amur? Let's go to another word. Kul a'udhu. A'udhu also is a word. I mean, this word, is it verb or noun? So this is the way. Inshallah ta'ala, for the last semester, the last 2 months, so we are going to learn the Arabic grammar. This contain nahwu, sarfu, and some balaga. So this is what we are planning for. Inshallah ta'ala, when we start, whoever ready to study Arabic in this way, just try to join us, and inshallah, you really appreciate this and you will never be disappointed. So that's what I want to tell you. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.
Jazakallah khairi ya Shaykh. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you in your life. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to benefit from your knowledge bi iznillah. So my dear brothers, this is our course, which is going to be first semester is going to be on 2 months, and our course is going to be start from the 29th of this particular month, 29th of August. So the classes will be only on Friday, Saturday and Sunday from Asr to Maghrib. Friday, Saturday, Sunday from Asr to Maghrib, yani from 5 p.m. to 7 p.m. this will be time for our classes biiznillah. And we are trying our level best that we buy a school van so that inshallah we pick up those brothers who will be a bit far from our place, inshallah. But for the meanwhile, inshallah, we will try to arrange some stuff that those people from Inti, from Nilai, who wants to join us in this particular course biiznillah, we will try to arrange something for them so that we can pick them also and we can drop them back also to their homes. The fee for this particular course, my dear brother, is 150 ringgit, and especially those out there who knows me already. So you know that we, alhamdulillah, we established the madarsa here for the kids who are poor, for the kids who are orphans, the kids who are homeless, the kids who couldn't be able to survive by themselves in terms of education or in terms of food or living. So alhamdulillah, we built this particular place and we have this particular place for all of those kids. So your fees, which is going to come, actually we don't want to be dependent on charity. We want to be independent, you know, in terms of running this particular madarsa. So whatever money is going to come, inshallah, we're going to put on our this madarsa biiznillah, and the remaining which we left, we will give to our sheikh in terms of salary, in terms of what he deserves to have in terms of this dunya. So come join us, let's learn the language of the Quran, and let's create a stronger and stronger relationship with the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and with the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Jazakallah khair, my dear brothers. Until next time, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.